ततो जयमुदीरये बिफोर रिसाइटिंग द श्रीमद् भागवतम विच इज द वेरी मीन्स ऑफ कॉन्क्वेस्ट वन शुड ऑफर रेस्पेक्टफुल ओबेसेंसेस अनटू द पर्सनालिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड नारायण अनटू नरनारायण ऋषि द सुपर मोस्ट ह्यूमन बीइंग अनटू मदर सरस्वती द गॉडेस ऑफ लर्निंग एंड अनटू शिल व्यासदेव द ऑथर अष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी बाय रेगुलर अटेंडेंस इन क्लासेस इन द भागवतम एंड बाय रेंडरिंग ऑफ सर्विस टू द प्योर डिवोटी ऑल दैट इज ट्रबलसम टू द हार्ट इज ऑलमोस्ट कंप्लीटली डिस्ट्रॉयड And loving service unto the personality of Godhead, whose praise with transcendental songs is established as an irrevocable fact. Send the verse. So we are reading the first canto, chapter 5, Narada's instructions on Srimad Bhagavatam, text number 28. Ittham Sarat. प्राब्रिस्को ऋतु हरे इत्थं शरत् प्राब्रिसिकौ ऋतु हरे विशृण्वतो मे अनुसवम् यसः अमलम् विशृण्वतो मे अनुसवम् यशो अमलम् संकीर्त्यमानम् मुनिभिः महात्माभिः संकीर्त्यमानम् मुनिभिर्महात्मभिः भक्तिः प्रवृत्ता आत्मा रजः तमः अपः भक्ति प्रवृत्ता आत्मा रजस्तमोपः इत्थं शरत् प्रावृषिकौ ऋतो हरेर् विशृण्वतो मे अनुसवं यशोमलम् संकीर्त्यमानं मुनिभिर्महात्मभिः भक्तिः प्रवृत्तात्मरजस्तमोपः इत्थं शरत्प्रावृषिकौ ऋतो हरेर् विशृण्वतो मेऽनुसवं यशोमलम् संकीर्त्यमानं मुनिभिर्महात्मभिः भक्ति प्रवृत्तात्मरजस्तमोपः इत्थं शरत्प्रावृषिकौ ऋतो हरेर् विशृण्वतो मेऽनुसवं यशोमलम् संकीर्त्यमानं मुनिभिर्महात्मभिः भक्तिः प्रवृत्तात्मरजस्तमोपः इत्थं शरत्प्रावृषिकौ ऋतो हरेर् विशृण्वतो मेऽनुसवं यशोमलम् संकीर्त्यमानं मुनिभिर्महात्मभिः भक्ति प्रवृतात्मरजस्तमोपः इत्थं शरत्प्रावृषिकौ ऋतो हरेर् Vishrinvato menusavam yashomalam. Sankirtyamanam munibhir mahatmabhir. Bhakti pravratatma rajastamopakam. What do you want to chant? Itham sarat pravrishika vritu harer. Itham sarat pravrishikau ritu hare. Vishrinvato menusavam yashomalam. Sankirtyamanam munibhir mahatmabhir. Bhakti pravratatma rajastamokaha. Tam sarat pram rishikau ritu hare. Vishrinvato menusavam yashomalam. Want to try? Try. Do you have any Itham sarat pravrishikau ritu hare. Vishrinvato menusavam yashomalam. Sankirtyamanam munibhir mahatmabhir. Bhakti pravratatma rajastamokaha. Itham sarat pravrishikau ritu harer. Vishrinvato menusavam yashomalam. All right.
Itham sarat pravrishikau ritu hare.
Itham sarat pravrishikau ritu hare.
Vishrinvato me anusavam yashomalam.
Vishrinvato me anusavam yashomalam.
Sankirtyamanam munibhir mahatmabhir.
Sankirtyamanam munibhir mahatmabhir.
Bhakti pravrittatma rajastamopaha.
Bhakti pravrittatma rajastamopaha.
Itham sarat pravrishikau ritu harer.
Itham sarat pravrishikau ritu harer.
Vishrinvato menusavam yashomalam.
Vishrinvato menusavam yashomalam.
Sankirtyamanam munibhir mahatmabhir.
Sankirtyamanam munibhir mahatmabhir.
Bhakti pravrutatma rajastamopaha.
Bhakti pravrutatma rajastamopaha. Synonyms. इत्थम दस शरत ऑटम प्राब्रिशिकौ रेनी सीजन ऋतु टू सीजन्स हरे हे ऑफ द लॉर्ड विश्रण्वतः कंटिन्यूअसली हियरिंग मे मायसेल्फ अनुसवम कॉन्स्टेंटली यसः अमलम अनअडल्टरेटेड ग्लोरीज संकीर्त्यमानम चैंटेड बाय मुनिभिः द ग्रेट सेजेस महाआत्मभिः ग्रेट सोल्स भक्तिः डिवोशनल सर्विस प्रवृत्ता बिगैन टू फ्लो आत्मा लिविंग बीइंग रजः मोड ऑफ पैशन तमा मोड ऑफ इग्नोरेंस उपहा बैनिशिंग Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Translation. Thus, during two seasons, the rainy season and autumn, I had the opportunity to hear these great soul sages constantly chant the unadulterated glories of the Lord Hari. As the flow of my devotional service began, the coverings of the modes of passion and ignorance vanished. Translation with repetition. Thus, during two seasons, the rainy season and autumn, I had the opportunity to hear these great-souled sages constantly chant the unadulterated glories of the Lord Hari. As the flow of my devotional service began, the coverings of the modes of passion and ignorance vanished. Transcendental loving service for the Supreme Lord is the natural inclination of every living being. The instinct is dormant in everyone, but due to the association of material nature, the modes of passion and ignorance cover this from time immemorial. If by the grace of the Lord and the great soul devotees of the Lord, a living being becomes fortunate enough to associate with the unadulterated devotees of the Lord and gets a chance to hear the unadulterated glories of the Lord, certainly the flow of devotional service takes place like the flow of a river. As the river flows on till it reaches the sea, similarly pure devotional service flows by the association of pure devotees till it reaches the ultimate goal, namely transcendental love of God. Such a flow of devotional service cannot stop. On the contrary, it increases more and more without limitation. The flow of devotional service is so potent that any onlooker also becomes liberated from the influence of the modes of passion and ignorance. These two qualities of nature are thus removed, and the living being is liberated, being situated in his original position. Ascends the wonderful transcendental Bhaktivedanta purport. Om Ajnana Timirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishthaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा राम राम हरे हरे Hare Krishna. So we have some new devotees here who have come for our Sunday, spiritual Sunday, Bhagavatam class and our morning program. So we welcome you all. Now, the verse that we are taking today, this is actually a dialogue which is happening between Narad Muni and Vedavyas. Narad Muni is the spiritual master of Vedavyas, and they are having this conversation. And during the course of this conversation, Narad Muni is talking about his past life, where he was actually in one of the most unfortunate situations ever possible. He was born as a son of a maid servant. His father was not there. He was very young. Imagine a maid servant who's working in your house if you are born as her son. So very, very difficult, unfortunate situations. But what did he do in his life? What happened? What are the sequence of events that happened in his life that made him Narad Muni? How did he become Narad Muni? That's what is the conversation. And Narad Muni is giving his own example that how he got purified. How from the most unfortunate situation, he became the most fortunate. So let us understand this verse a little more, and then we will see some points which Prabhupada is mentioning in the purport. Very interesting verse. So the verse is, Ittham sarat pra vrishikau ritu hare vishrin vato menu savam yashomalam sankirtyamanam munibhir mahatmabhir Bhakti Prabhutatma Rajastamopaha. Itham, the word itham means thus. The word thus is used in English when you have said some things. Before that, there are some things that you have referred to in the beginning or before that. And then the word comes thus. So what is referred to in the previous verse? If we see the last verse that we had taken, O great sage, as soon as I got a taste of the personality of Godhead, my attention to hear of the Lord was unflinching. There was one word which was used in the last verse. It's called Askhalita Mati. Mati, which is Askhalita. Askhalita Mati is uninterrupted attention. So as soon as I developed an attraction for the Supreme Personality of Godhead, my attention to hear of the Lord was unflinching. A little attraction when it comes in the conditioned living entity, we don't have any attraction for the Lord. But when an attraction develops for the Lord, when I understand his position, when I understand that I need to establish a relationship with him, there is an attention which comes for this Krishna Katha. There is a person becomes attentive to hear. Otherwise, attention is not there. You may come, but mind will be somewhere else. You may be sitting here, but something else will be going on. So he said, my attention to hear of the Lord was unflinching. And as my taste developed, I could realize it was only in my ignorance that I had accepted gross and subtle coverings, for both the Lord and I are transcendental. Only in ignorance one accepts this covering of the soul as himself. There are two kinds of coverings to the soul. One is the gross, one is the subtle. Gross covering is the material body that we see ourselves every day in the mirror when we stand and see. This is the body that we have. And the body constantly changes, deteriorates. A person, when he has accepted the body of a human form, he is born as a small baby, grows, becomes an adult, and then grows old, and then one day he quits his body. But there is a subtle covering also. It is made up of mana, buddhi, ankar, mind, intelligence, and false ego. This is a covering of the soul. So he's telling, as I started hearing, I could... as my taste developed, I could realize it was only my ignorance that I had accepted gross and subtle coverings, but both the Lord and I are transcendental. So he developed an unflinching attention. The taste for hearing developed. He understood that these coverings are superficial, superfluous. They're just coverings because we are transcendental. And then what happened? Ittham, thus, Sharat Prabhrishikau Rutu Harer. In our Vedic culture, there are these 4 months which are called Chaturmasya. In that 4 months period, these 2 months, Sharat and Pravrishikau, Sharat month, the autumn, and rainy season, these 2 seasons, where those Bhaktivedantas who were traveling and they were seated in Narad Muni's house, they had stayed there, Narad Muni heard them. Ittham Sharat Pravrishikau Ritu Harer. Vishrinvato is to hear. How did he hear? Continuously. The word continuously, if you see, is used twice here in this verse. Vishrinvataha anusavam. Constantly. Sometimes we come and hear this instructions of Krishna or the glories of Krishna, but we again get going with our life. We get busy and engaged in our life. We forget about this. But the one of the qualifications that is required to hear is Vishrinvataha and Anusavam, continuously hearing and constantly. So Ittham Sharat Pra Vrishika Urte Harir Vishrinvataha Me Anusavam Yasha Amalam. What did he hear? He heard the unadulterated glories of the Lord. Now this word also is a very important thing. You may go to some professional reciter of Srimad Bhagavatam who is also glorifying the Lord. But the motivation behind glorifying the Lord is to earn some money, to earn livelihood. That is not Yasho Amalam. That is not Amala Yasha. Unadulterated glories. There is no tinge of adulteration. There is no motive behind glorification of the Lord. So he heard, Narada Muni heard continuously, constantly, Yasha Amalam. Where did he hear this from? Sankirtyamanam Munibhirar Mahatmakar. So this great souls, these great sages, Sankirtyamanam, they were continuously chanting. The great souls do not have anything else to do. They are busy glorifying the Lord. They are always busy, absorbed in thoughts of Krishna, very deeply absorbed. Sankirtyamanam Munibhir Mahatmakar. Bhakti Pravritta Atma. Bhakti Pravritta. Then what happened? The devotional service began to flow. Bhakti Pravritta Atma Rajastamopaha. And when the devotional service began to flow in his heart, the influence of Rajas and Tama Apaha became vanished. So this is the verse. During the two seasons, the rainy season in the autumn, I had the opportunity to hear these great soul sages constantly chant the unadulterated glories of the Lord Hari. As the flow of my devotional service began, the coverings of the modes of passion and ignorance vanished. If we see the translation a little more closely, the points that I want to highlight, if you see the second box, two seasons, rainy and autumn, fine. I had the opportunity to hear this great soul sages. This is a rare opportunity in human form of life to get a chance to hear from a pure devotee. So he's telling here, it's great soul sages, Mahatma Bhir, Muni Bhir. Here these great soul sages constantly, Anusavam, chant the unadulterated glories of the Lord Hari, Yasha Amalam. As the flow of my devotional service began, the coverings of the modes of passion and ignorance vanished. The coverings of the modes of passion and ignorance vanished. So there is a covering of this mode of passion and ignorance as long as we are there in this material world. Now let us understand what happens when we are there in this material world and we have the influence of these lower modes, the modes of passion and ignorance. What it does is actually it creates a lot of desires in our mind. A lot of desires, unlimited desires. Mind is a thought-producing machine which produces thoughts continuously. Even when we are asleep, we get dreams. Constant thoughts, desires, which are produced. And since most of the time in this material world, we are under the influence of the mode of ignorance and passion, the desires produced are not conducive for our living here. It creates more anxiety. And the cousin brother of anxiety is fear. Fear of material existence. What will happen to me? What will happen to my children? What will happen to my parents? What will happen to whom? All kinds of anxiety and fear. That is why the verse in Bhagavatam it is saying, Yasyam vaishruyamanayam krishne paramapuruṣe utpadyate bhaktir pumsa sokam moha bhaya apaha. The word same, apaha, is used here as in this verse that we are seeing. Tamo apaha. Yasyam vaishruyamanayam. When we hear about Krishna, when we pay attention to this activities, this narrations, this transcendental instructions, Yashyam vai shruyamanayam krishne parama purusha, about the Lord, bhaktir utpadyate pumsa, then the bhakti is aroused in our heart. When the bhakti is aroused, bhaktir utpadyate pumsa, soka moha bhayaka. There are three things. How many of you, while working, while doing your work, put on some background music? You do. It helps in doing some work, right? Some background music. Actually, this verse of Bhagavatam is telling everybody in this material world, they're constantly hearing a background music. Here you don't have a choice of what background music you want to hear. It's constantly being played. What is that background music? Soka moha bhaya. There is lamentation for things that you could not do in life. I want to achieve, I want to do this, I could not get it. I wanted to get into IIT, didn't get it. So I keep lamenting about it. Soka, moha, moha is illusion. These are all mine. Somehow I should keep them with me. I should protect them. This is my land, this is my house. My house is now, there's a crack coming up. There's something happening. What do I do? How do I maintain them? Moha and bhaya, fear of losing everything. Now becoming old, I'll become disabled. I'll not have money. I'll not have some resource. So what will happen? Who will take care of my dependents? Where will I go? Or if what if, you know, the knowledge, the skills that I have becomes obsolete? What if, you know, something else happens and there is a fear of losing? But the verse is telling, Yashyam vai shuyamanayam krishne paramapurushe utpadyate bhakti pumsam soka moha bhayapaha. Apaha, this vanishes. When the bhakti develops in the heart by constant hearing, Yashyam vai shuyamanayam krishne paramapurushe utpadyate bhakti pumsam soka moha bhayapaha. All this fear, lamentation, and this illusion that people are suffering, the background music which is going on where you don't know how to turn it off, it will become completely vanished. Very interestingly, in one of the purports, Srila Prabhupada actually explains what happens when these desires are produced. And we don't know when this constant, because even the scientists, they say that an average healthy person produces about 90,000 thoughts a day. And 90% of these thoughts are negative and repetitive. Same things keep coming again and again, again and again. So if that is the case, what happens if those desires are not checked or we don't know what to do with those desires? What will happen? So this is a very beautiful purport that Prabhupada is explaining, those desires. What is the effect of that on us? Material desires in the mind are the trash of material contamination. The desires are trash. Imagine you have a trash can. What do you throw in trash? Good things, whatever is valuable. Nice things, you take them, put it in the trash. No. What do you put there? Not useful. Useless things, which are absolutely of no use, unnecessary, throw them in the trash. Material desires in the mind are the trash of material contamination. These desires are not very supportive, conducive, productive for us. These are trash of material contamination. Because the soul, which is trapped in this gross and subtle body in this material world, is associating with this material world, the modes of material nature, he's generating these thoughts, these desires, which are trash. Material desires in the mind are the trash of the material contamination. By such contamination, the living being is faced with so many compatible and incompatible things that discourage the very existence of spiritual identity. So what happens when we associate with these modes? Mind you, this material nature, the modes are constantly acting. You don't have a choice. Okay, I'll be, for this point in time, I want to be immune. I don't want to be under the influence of these modes of material nature. You don't have a choice. They constantly are acting on us. Somehow you get the inspiration to come, some mode of goodness is acting. You thought, no, let me go and attend the temple program in the morning. It's a mode of goodness. Next moment it says, oh, today is Sunday. Let me go and work out, do something so that, you know, I can make some progress in my life, in my career, in my professional life. Let me develop some skills, mode of passion. Or you feel, oh, enough, I went in the morning, let me go and sleep nicely. This mode of ignorance. It is constantly acting. How a person acts helplessly, he doesn't know that the modes of material nature are influencing his choices, but he's unaware. That is why this is called Daivihi Esha Gunamai. The Gunamai Maya, it is acting. And it is like, you know, the puppets which are being controlled. Like that we are controlled, but we think we are independent. So here it is mentioned that when we are acting, when this contamination is acting on us, then we develop something called compatible and incompatible things that discourage the very existence of spiritual identity. We always want to remain in the bodily concept of life. This is the biggest illusion we think we are body, we live our life with that strong conception that I am this body, and we die with that conception. Birth after birth, the conditioned soul is entrapped with so many pleasing and displeasing elements which are false and temporary. They accumulate due to our reactions to material desires. And there is a but, and this but is a very significant one. But when we get in touch with the transcendental Lord in his variegated energies by devotional service, the naked forms of all material desires become manifest, and the intelligence of the living being is pacified in its true color. Now, the intelligence is also not even pacified. It all happens when somebody comes in touch with the variegated energy of the Lord. When we get in touch with the transcendental Lord in his variegated energies by devotional service, the naked forms of all material desires become manifest, and the intelligence of the living being is pacified in its true color. Unless the intelligence is pacified, we go on. It goes on churning more and more desires, more and more desires. So how will you bring a full stop to this? It's only possible when somebody comes in touch with the Lord through devotional service. As soon as Arjuna turned his attention towards the instruction of the Lord, as they are inculcated in the Bhagavad Gita, his true color of eternal association with the Lord became manifest. Thus, he felt freed from all material contaminations. Arjuna had attained this stage long before on the battlefield of Kurukshetra. And when he apparently felt the absence of the Lord, he at once took shelter of the instructions of the Bhagavad Gita, and thus again he was placed in his original position. This is the position of Bishoka, or the stage of being freed from all grief and anxieties. Instructions of Bhagavad Gita are transcendental because the Lord is transcendental. Whatever is coming out of his mouth is also transcendental. So when we hear these transcendental instructions, not coming from ordinary human being, from the Supreme Lord, who is our biggest well-wisher, Suhrudam Sarva Bhutanam, he wants the well-being of each one of us, more than any of our family members, relatives, more than we ourselves. Interestingly, in Bhagavatam 10th canto, there is a question that is asked. The question is, whom do you love the most? Whom do you love? Think. One person. Who said self? That's the right answer. We love the most our own self. No, you may say, no, I'm very attached to my mother, very attached to my wife, very attached to my children. Somebody may say, I'm a patriot, I'm attached to my country, I'm attached to my community. It is because we love ourselves the most that we love the country that I'm born in, the members that they're attached to me. I'm attached to a phone which I am using, even though the phone may not be, the best of the phones. But since this is my phone, I'm attached to it. Maybe there is some scratch, maybe there is some crack. But when two phones are lying outside and you have a choice, somebody is not on mute. Can you please go on mute? So when my phone is lying there and the other phone, I pick up my phone. I want to take care of that phone first before I don't care because it is not mine. Because we love ourselves the most, hence the bodily identifications. These are my family members. This is my country, India, Bharat Mata. If you are born in Pakistan, it would have been Pakistan Mata. Like they say that. I don't know if they say or not. But just because I am born in Bharat, India, so Bharat Mata ki jai. And so the person that we love the most is our own self. And Bhagavatam says, why do we love ourselves the most? Why do we love ourselves the most? Why do you love yourself the most? Okay, who answered the answer? We are the only one exist. The reason is because we think we are eternal. I'm going to live forever. This is the nature of the soul. The soul is eternal, Sat Chit and Ananda. But because there is contaminations, there is the covering that I'm thinking this body. And because, imagine if you are asked to go and be on the sea or in a river in a boat. Four of you together, you're all good friends. You're asked, you be in the sea for one day. So you enjoy a nice sea. It's a beautiful weather, no rain, nothing. If there is rain also, you have roof, nothing to worry about. You are there. One day, 2 days, 3 days, 4 days, 5 days. You want to come? No. You'll be there only. So if you continue to remain there, will you be comfortable in that place? Why you will not be comfortable? The reason you are not comfortable is because you don't belong to that place. This place, we are the creatures of this earth. When we are here, we feel safe, secure. But when we go into that sea, it is not our natural state. And when we are not in our natural state, I'm feeling fear of the sea. I'm feeling that there could be some seasickness. I could feel, I could have some problem. What if something happens and I'm not able to protect myself? There is always this anxiety. Similarly, in this material world, when we are accepting ourselves as a body, this is not our natural position. We are feeling the fear. Our environment is in this asat, in this temporary world, whereas the spirit soul is sat. The sat is put into this asat environment, so there is always constant fear, anxiety. What will happen? What will happen? What will happen? Once understands that actually I'm a spirit soul, I've got nothing to do with this. They're all temporary designations and identifications I've created for myself. And when he realizes his true position and works towards it to remove, get rid of all these contaminations, that he comes out to his natural state, where he becomes completely free from all these things and he can go back home, back to God. One thing which I have highlighted here is when we get in touch with the transcendental Lord in his variegated energies by devotional service, the naked forms of all material desires become manifest and the intelligence of the living being is pacified in its true color. There is a very beautiful verse in Bhagavatam which comes. It is an instruction by Kapila Dev to his mother, Devahuti. And in that verse, Kapila Muni is telling Devahuti, Mad guna sruti matrena, mai sarva guha saye, mano gatir abichinna, yatha gangam bhaso ambodho. Mad guna sruti matrena. Lord Kapila is actually an incarnation of the Lord. So he is telling Mad guna, means my qualities. Shruti matrena. If you just hear the qualities of the Lord, the qualities of the Lord are so attractive. Who attracts us in this material world? Who attracts you, Mataji? Whom do you get enamored by? Like? Huh? Which person? Let me be specific, not desires. Whom do you, when do you see some, when, who is the person whom you see when you feel someone who's very knowledgeable? What is that depends? Whom do you feel when you meet, oh my God, I met someone? Or whom do you look up to? Who's your role model? Who is that? Tell one name. You're giving in material world. Who's better than you? In what way? Maybe you're CEO of your company. Maybe. Yeah, maybe. Depends on the surroundings. But who are the general people that we look up to? Maybe a sports person who's excelling in his field. Maybe a politician who's not corrupt. Maybe a beautiful person. Aishwarya Rai walks in. Not Aishwarya, whoever is now walks in. They will look, oh my God, that's great. We get attracted. So what our scriptures are telling that the living entities, all of us, we have certain qualities to very minute scale, very little. Somebody is little beautiful. Somebody is little rich. Somebody is little knowledgeable. Somebody is little renunciant. It attracts. Oh, he's a renunciant. Oh, he's so beautiful. Oh, he's so strong. Some strong person walks in. Beautiful body. We get attracted. There is an impression which gets created. But the Lord is actually he is filled with all these transcendental qualities. There is a verse by Parasar Muni where he says, Aishwaryasya samagrasya viryasya yasasashriya. Aishwaryasya Samagrasya. There are six opulences which the Lord has simultaneously in fullness. What are they? What is that? Okay, wealth. So Lord Krishna, when he was present here, he married 16,108 wives. And he had 16,108 palaces for them. Those palaces were bedecked with jewels and other valuable gems and stones. Opulences, can anybody say? Okay, somebody may say that, okay, I am Lakhpati, I am Karodpati, I am Arabpati, but Krishna is Lakshmipati. Match the wealth if you can match. Put all the wealth of all the wealthy people together. Krishna is still superior. So, Aishwaryasya, then Virya, potent, powerful. He lifted the Govardhan in his, the left hand smallest finger for 7 days and seven nights. When he was a 7-year-old boy. Is there anybody who can say, I'm more powerful, I can lift Govardhan Hill? Lift. So many powerful demons attacked Vrindavan. They're all saved by the Lord Krishna. Full of potency, strength. Then, beauty, Krishna's beauty, my God. What to speak of Krishna's beauty? There is a verse, I must say that verse. The verse is in the Bhagavatam 10th canto. This is a verse which is... So Rukmini Devi, she is telling a very wonderful verse. How many of you know who is Rukmini? Krishna's wife? Okay. What else you know? What else you know about Rukmini? How did Rukmini marry Krishna? Anybody knows? Yeah, how? He went. He kidnapped. We can say that. He actually kidnapped Rukmini. So, how did Krishna come to kidnap Rukmini? Very interestingly, Rukmini Devi actually writes a letter to Krishna. And she sends it through one of the messengers, and the messenger gives that to Krishna. What did she write? This is the first love letter. So it's not that, nowadays only people are doing it. It's there. Rukmini Devi writes, Shrutva Gunan. Shrutva Gunan Bhuvana Sundaram Shrinvatam Te Nirvishyakarna Vivarer Haratongatapam. Shrutva Gunan. I just heard. Actually, she has never seen who Krishna is. But she just heard. Shrutva Gunan Bhuvana Sundara. You are Bhuvana Sundara. You are so beautiful, your form. I've heard about it. Not just your form, your qualities. You are so attractive. Shrutva Gunan Bhuvana Sundara Shrinvatam Te Nirvishyakarna Vivarer Haratongatapam. I just heard about the glories, the beauty, all these descriptions from the pure devotees. Like Narad Muni used to visit and he used to glorify the Lord, and she heard. What happened when I heard? Nirvishyakarna Vivarer Haratongatapam. Tapam, this tritapa which torments us, this material miseries, this mode of passion and ignorance and this goodness, when it acts on us, it torments us. There is a heat. Shrutva nirvishyakarna vivarer haratongatapam. Harato angatapam. All this became completely vanished, removed. Angatapam of the bodies. And then, rupam drisham drishimatam akhilarthalabham. Tvai achyuta vishati chittam apatram me. He's saying, I'm shamelessly getting attracted to you. Just by hearing the form, the beauty. Actually, Krishna's form. There is a very powerful Vaishnava saint who has written this beautiful composition, which is where he's telling the beauty of Krishna, he's describing. That is, what is that verse? I'll just tell you, just give me 1 minute. Adharam Adharam. This verse, this song is actually, it is written by Vallabhacharya, one of the Acharyas, and he's telling how beautiful Krishna is. He's just glorifying because we're talking about the form. So he's telling, Adharam Adharam वदनं मधुरं नयनं मधुरं हसितं मधुरं हृदयं मधुरं गमनं मधुरं मधुराधिपतेरखिलं मधुरं. Balavacharya, when he wants to describe about Krishna, he's telling Adharam, the lips of Krishna is Madhuram, sweet, nectarian. Adharam Madhuram, Vadanam Madhuram. His body is Madhuram. Nayanam Madhuram, his eyes are beautiful. Hasitam Madhuram, what to speak about a smile, it's also very beautiful. Hridayam Madhuram, his heart is Madhuram. Gamanam Madhuram, his walk is beautiful. He says, I can't describe anymore. Madhuram, Madhuradhipater Akhilam Madhuram. Everything about him is Madhuram. Then he says, but he still tries. Vachanam Madhuram, Charitam Madhuram, Vasanam Madhuram, Balitam Madhuram, Chalitam Madhuram, Bramitam Madhuram, Madhuradhipater Akhilam Madhuram. Vachanam, his speech, his words are Madhuram. Charitam, his activities are Madhuram. It's wonderful to hear this pastime. Unfortunately, because of our conditioning, because of the conditioned state, since we don't have a taste, we are finding taste in other things, like I was telling yesterday, Netflix and other things. We are so attracted. But if we get just attracted to Krishna's gunas, Krishna's qualities, so we spoke about his strength, we spoke about his wealth, we spoke about his beauty, then what else? Knowledge. Krishna's knowledge. 5,000 years back, this Bhagavad Gita was spoken. Still, people are trying to understand what is this Bhagavad Gita all about. Knowledge, then renunciation. Which one? Fame. Yeah. Fame. Also, Krishna's Amala Yasa. Today's verse is telling Amala Yasa. Unadulterated glories of Krishna. When somebody hears, there is so many people who have come and gone, but the glories of Krishna is still, it is creating that attraction. And renunciation, even though he was, he did this very confidential pastime called Rasalila. He married 16,108 wives. When it came actually to Rajasuya Yajna, where Yudhishthira was choosing who is the right person who should sit, who should preside in this Yajna, people said it should be Bhishma Dev, because he is a lifelong brahmachari, a celibate. But Bhishma Dev himself says, when Lord Krishna is present, I cannot sit there because he is more celibate, more renounced than me. How? Had it been me in his place, I don't know what I would have done, because this kind of things is completely detached. Once he left Vrindavan, he never came back, because there is another reason for that. But he's fully renounced in this. So, Madguna Sruti Matrena Mai Sarva Guhasaye Manogatir Avichinna Yatha Gangam Bhasom Ambadho. Madguna Shruti Matrena, when we hear the transcendental glories of the Lord, just Shruti Matrena, just little you hear, who is the Supreme Lord, you heard about him. So I was telling, in material world, we get attracted to all these things. When somebody has a little quality of any of those things, he becomes attracted. What to speak of the Supreme Lord, who has got unlimited qualities and in fullness, simultaneously present. How attractive. That is why another name, the name Krishna means all attractive. The Lord is all attractive. The meaning of the word Krishna is all attractive. Madguna Shruti Matrena Mai Sarva Guhasaye. Actually, Krishna is telling, I am there in your heart. Mai Sarva Guhasaye. Manogatir Abhichinna Yatha Gangam Bhasam Bodhu. Like Ganges is flowing continuously to the sea. Once one get attracted to Krishna, Mai Sarva Guhasaye, who is seated in the heart, Manogatir Abhichinna, then the mind will automatically flow towards him. Automatically will flow towards. The translation of this verse is, the manifestation of unadulterated devotional service is exhibited when one's mind is at once attracted to hearing the transcendental name and qualities of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who's residing in everyone's heart. Just as the water of the Ganges flows naturally down towards the ocean, such devotional ecstasy, uninterrupted by any material condition, flows towards the Supreme Lord. So just when the mind is attracted to hearing the transcendental name qualities of the Lord, who is residing in everyone's heart, Mai Sarva Guhasaye, then just as the water of the Ganges flows naturally towards the ocean. Now, the reason why we should hear Krishna Katha, of course, this verse is only talking about that. This is from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's conclusion, and with this probably we will close. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says, what are the Vedic literatures all about? What is the Vedic literature? What are they trying to point out? In Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Vedescha sarve rahameva vedyam. There is no other reason for studying Vedic literatures. It is only to know me. Vedescha sarve rahameva vedyam vedanta brit. Vedanta krit vedabit chaham. So I am the compiler of Vedas, I am the knower of Vedas, and the purpose of reading Vedas is to know me. Vedescha sarve rahameva vedyam. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says in Chaitanya Charitamrita, there are only three things which are mentioned in Vedic Sastra. Veda Sastra kahe sambandha abhideya prayojana. Krishna prapya sambandha bhakti praptera sadha. Abhideya nama bhakti prema prayojana purushartha siromani prema maha dhananan. So, Veda Sastra kahe sambandha abhideya prayojana. There are three things which are mentioned in the Vedic literature. First thing is sambandha. Sambandha means relationship. In each one of us, we have a very strong, unique relationship with Krishna, which exists lifetime after lifetime. Even though we change bodies, even though in this life we are changing bodies, that relationship is there. Unfortunately, we don't know, and that relationship is very, very weak. So first thing he's telling is, understand who the Lord is. What is his position? Who are you with respect to him? And develop that relationship, sambandha. Once the sambandha, once we understand the Lord and we understand that we have an eternal relationship with him, how do I revive that relationship? That abhidheya is the part or the process by which I can revive the relationship. Just by telling, will that relationship be revived? Will I understand the Lord is there? I have a relationship with him? No. There is a process which is given, and the process is devotional life, devotional service. Navabhidha bhakti, shravanam, kirtanam, vishnu. First is shravanam. Shravanam, kirtanam, vishnu. Smaranam Pada Sevanam Archanam Vandanam Dasyam Sakyam Atman Vedanam. Shravanam Kirtanam Vishnu. Hear about Vishnu. Kirtanam, know about, not about Kali. Shravanam Kirtanam Vishnu. Smaranam. Then remember his pastimes. By this process, Abhidheya, the establishing of relationship becomes manifested. How do I establish my relationship? Once that is done, Abhidheya, then there is a prayojana, goal. What is the use? What is the ultimate destination of having established our relationship with the Lord? Prayojana is we develop a love for Krishna. Krishna prema, the highest treasure in this material world. Krishna prema. The Vedic literatures give information about the living entity's eternal relationship with Krishna, which is called sambandha. The living entity's understanding of this relationship and his acting accordingly is called abhidheya. Returning home back to Godhead is the ultimate goal of life and is called prayojana. If there is no goal, why should we do something? The goal is to return home back to home, back to Godhead. No more taking birth in this material world, going back home, back to Godhead. To do that, there is a process, abhidheya. The first thing is sambandha, relationship with the Lord. There is a process by which you can establish that relationship. And once you establish the relationship, what happens? You go back home, back to Godhead. Devotional service or sense activity for the satisfaction of the Lord is called abhidheya because it can develop one's original love of Godhead, which is the goal of life. The goal is the living entity's topmost interest and greatest wealth. As I said, everybody wants to love himself the most. They're very selfish. But we don't know that the topmost interest and the greatest wealth of all our lives is to go back to Godhead. Prahlad Maharaj says in his prayers in Bhagavatam, Nate Viduhu. Swartha Gatim Hi Vishnu. Ate Viduhu. We don't know that the real goal and destination of our life is to go back home, back to God. Thus one attains the platform of transcendental loving service unto the Lord. Before I close for today, I wanted you to remember this song which Prabhupada wrote when he came here to the Commonwealth Pier in Boston when he arrived here in the cargo ship. There's this very, you know, if you see his position, a 70-year-old man arriving in the US by the order of his spiritual master to spread this message. And he didn't go and approach any Indians here. He didn't find who's there who can help me. And neither at that time, not so many Indians were present. Whoever came in his way, he spoke to them, unadulterated glories of the Lord. And he had this firm conviction within the heart that the Krishna prema is dormant in every single person's heart. Nitya siddha Krishna prema sadhya kabunaye shravanadi suddha chitte karaye udaye. Firm conviction, each one of us, doesn't matter who you are, how much you are averse to Krishna, you are an agnostic, doesn't matter, you are an atheistic, fine. You are a worshipper of somebody else, still Krishna prema is dormant in everybody's heart. Nitya siddha Krishna prema sadhya kabunaye shravanadi suddha chitte. When we hear about the Lord, when we hear his instructions, chitta becomes suddha. The consciousness, the mind, the chitta, it becomes free from all the impressions, from the material contaminations. Sravanadi suddha chitta karayuda, it becomes manifest. And that's exactly what happened when Prabhupada spoke this knowledge, this instruction of Krishna. It brought the transformation in those hippies, those simple people who were coming in touch. So when he wrote this song, he's telling, Goro Kripa, Goro Kripa Koile Krishna Adha Mera Prati Kila Giya Nile Heta Goro Ebe Gati Goro Kripa Koile Krishna Adha Mera Prati. Krishna has done some great, by his great mercy, he has brought me here. Paro Kripa Koile Krishna Adhamera Prati. Adhama, he is considering himself to be Adhama, that you are so kind upon this useless soul, but I do not know why you have brought me here. Now you can do whatever you like with me. And then he says in the next stanza, Ache ki chuka jatave anu mane nahe keno ani mene ei ugra sthane. So, but I guess you have some business here. Otherwise, why would you bring me to this terrible place? So the place which we consider the best place, especially some part of our country, there is a great aspiration to come to this place under any circumstances. Right? There is one temple in Andhra Pradesh, Visa Balaji, right? We'll go and do some so that they can come get the visa and come to this country. But he's telling this is a terrible place. But I guess you have some business here. Otherwise, why would you bring me to this terrible place? Why it is a terrible place? Prabhupada says in the third stanza, Rajastamo gune rasabai achanna Vasudeva katharuchi nahe se prasanna. Why it is a terrible place? Because the most of the population here is covered by the material modes of ignorance and passion. They are covered with this. Absorbed in material life, they think themselves very happy and satisfied. And therefore, they have no taste for the transcendental message of Vasudeva. I do not know how they will be able to understand it. So he's telling me, I have no idea how they will understand it. Because they are all covered with ignorance and passion. They just want, this is just absorbed in material life. Then he says, the fourth one, Tabe jadi tab kripa hoye ahe tuki sakale sambhav hoye tumi se kautuki. It requires some the mercy, and the mercy has to be causeless. Only if there is a causeless mercy of the Lord, that can one come out of this influence of modes of material. It's extremely difficult. Daivihi esha gunamai mama maya duratyaya mameva ye prapatyante maya metam paranti. Only by your causeless mercy can make everything possible, because you are the most expert mystic. And then the one that I wanted to you to pay attention is, tumara ichchaya sabha hoy maya basa tumara ichchaya nasa maya ra paras. By the Lord's arrangement only we come under the influence of external energy, maya basa. And by the Lord's arrangement only we can come out of it. So how is it possible? Tava ichcha hoye jodi tadera udhara bujhibe nischaye tabe katha se tomara bhagavatera katha se taba avatara dhira haiya sune jodi kane bara bara. If you see this verse, the line that I just sang, eighth verse, the words of Srimad Bhagavatam are your incarnation. And if a sober person, dhira haiya, repeatedly receives it with submissive oral reception, then he'll be able to understand your message. And then he goes on to speak those verses, Srimatam Sukatha Krishna Punya Shravanam Kirtana. The हृदयंतस्थो हि अवत्राणि विधुनोति सुहृत्सुत सो ऑन एंड सो फॉर्थ बट द इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज टू रिपीटेडली हियर दिस इंस्ट्रक्शंस ऑफ कृष्णा फ्रॉम अ प्योर डिवोटी ऑफ द लॉर्ड देन देयर इज द फ्लो ऑफ डिवोशनल सर्विस व्हिच हैपेंस इन आवर हार्ट इट फ्लोस कंटिन्यूअसली टू दैट सी व्हिच इज लव ऑफ गॉड फॉर द डिवोशनल सर्विस टू फ्लो एक्चुअली द फ्लोइंग ऑफ डिवोशनल सर्विस इज मेंशनड Because after taking to this devotional service, still there are anarthas which come. They hinder our growth. Sometimes at the beginning we feel, yes, now I am initiated, I am ready to do anything. But after some time, the same service when it is asked, we don't show up. We're not there. We don't have taste. Because there are anarthas in our heart. The anarthas start manifesting when we start engaging in devotional service. So here in this verse is telling, As my devotional service began, the coverings of the modes of passion and ignorance vanished. So the coverings of passion and ignorance takes time to go. Very interestingly, if we hear those demons killed by Krishna in Vrindavan, they represent various anarthas in our heart. Name, fame, no submissiveness, false ego. There are so many problems in our heart. How will it go? Obedience is the first thing. Very important thing in our spiritual life. Unless they go, the covering, these are all the products of this coverings of ignorance and passion. When ignorance and passion is covering us, this anartha start manifesting. So the way to overcome them is to do the first three things properly. Adho shraddha, atha sadhu, sangha, atha bhajana kriya, atha anartha nivritti. So if there is no bhajana kriya, if there is no sadhu sangha, anarthas will not go from our heart. And then anarthas, if they don't go, then we can't achieve the perfection of this devotional life. So these are some of the points from this verse, from this beautiful, wonderful verse and such a beautiful purport. If anybody has any questions or comments, clarifications. Any question? Ravi. Anything that you heard which you want to repeat? I didn't talk about that. So whatever we discussed, anything that struck today, what we discussed now. True. I mean, Krishna prema or the love of God is something which is dormant in our heart. Because we don't know our position and the position of the Lord, that love manifests here in this material world as lust, where we want to gratify our senses. So the pure love is unconditional and that is dormant. And that, how does that arise in the heart? Nitya Siddha Krishna Prema Sadhya Kabunaya Shravanadi Suddha Chitte. Shravanadi Suddha Chitte. This is what it is by hearing about Krishna Gatha, by hearing repeatedly, continuously. Okay. We are all confused in the material world. You are not any exception. But the confusion can go. Clarity can come. If we want to associate, we want to hear the instruction of a pure devotee. If we come in touch with a pure devotee, which is not an ordinary thing. Brahmanda Brahmite Kona Bhagyavan Jeev Guru Krishna Prasada Pai Bhaktilata Beach. You may wander to different places from America to India to Switzerland to Baya, wherever you want to go, or different planets also. Brahmanda Brahmite Kona Bhagyavan. you're not fortunate if you get a job in Intel or in some other good company or you become a CEO. Kono bhagyavan, the real fortunate person is he who gets Bhakti Lata Beech, the seed of devotion. That doesn't come easily. How does it come? Guru Krishna Prasadapaya, by the mercy of Guru and Krishna. You have anything to say on today's? Should say one thing. You have to tell one point. Actually, you see how difficult it is to even recollect 45 minutes, 1 hour I spoke, right? But our mind, our attention, where it is. If you would have heard, this is exactly what is happening to us in this conditioned state, in this material world, where our attention span is very low. We have filters in our mind. We are sitting here. Yes, tell me what I can do. But you tell me, give me a glass of water. No, you don't have. I'm asking. That means it is implied. There is an action. You have to go and fetch some water. But then what happens is, because in our mind we don't know what we heard. So give me a glass of water and the person still looks at you. Like that, Krishna is telling Sarva Dharman Parityajya Mamekam Sharanam Braja Aham Tvam Sarva Papekta Mokshesyami Masucha. Give up all this kind of thing, engagements, duties that you've created for yourself. Just surrender unto me. Aham Tvam Sarva Papekta Mokshesyami Masucha. I will protect you from all kinds of the sinful reactions. Sarva Papebhyo Mokshayisyami. Masucha, don't fear. I'm little contemplating him. This is our state, where we are. And we continue to remain like this in this material world forever. Suffer, suffer, suffer. Still we think, yeah, this is a great place. The life goes like that. So only when we hear the words, the instruction of a pure devotee, when we associate with him, when we hear about the glories of the Lord, when we understand what is our position, why are we suffering here? This covering is superfluous, this material covering. I am eternal. That we work towards it to go back home, back to God. Arthaji, one point. Good point. Yes. Yes. Very nice. Anybody online? Any point anybody wants to share? Any question? One. Jajati. Bhagavat Tattva Prabhu. Muted? Oh, okay. They're all muted. Can you unmute yourself now, bro?
Yeah, now it's possible.
Yeah. Jayati, you have anything to share?
No, actually, nothing.
Okay, Bhagavad Tattva Prabhu.
Yes, Prabhu. Talked about who is the most dear in this material world is oneself is the most dear, because we are eternal soul full of Sat Chit Ananda.
Okay, right. If nothing else, we will continue to see this wonderful journey of Narad Muni, how he got transformed, how he became the eternal associate of the Lord from the most unfortunate situation. What were the factors which helped him to overcome his misfortune or his precarious situation, which all of us are in? So we will stop here and again have the discussion next week. Grantharaj Srimad Bhagavatam ki Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki Nitai Gaur Karmanande Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.